The Carolina Bays are shallow elliptical depressions along the east coast of the United States. They occur on unconsolidated soil, close to the water table, and their major axis is oriented toward the Great Lakes. Impacts and the action of wind and water have been proposed as mechanisms for the origin of the bays, but the heart-shaped bays are explained more satisfactorily as the result of impacts. Michael Davies established a database of LIDAR images accessible to the public in the website cintos.org. Examination of the images shows that overlapping Carolina bays are very common. A large Carolina bay can partially cover a smaller one. A small Carolina bay may partially cover a larger bay or may be completely contained within a larger bay. The overlaps correspond to the sequence of formation following the principle of superposition. In 1952, Professor Prouty proposed that overlapping Carolina bays were created by impacts of tandem meteorites. At that time, the Nebraska rainwater basins with the same elliptical geometry as the Carolina bays had not been discovered yet, and Prouty proposed that the bays had been created by extraterrestrial impacts. The glacier ice impact hypothesis, published in 2017, proposed that the Carolina bays were produced by impacts of glacier ice chunks ejected in ballistic trajectories by a meteorite impact on the Laurentide ice sheet. Ice chunks were ejected at various angles and speeds. The impacts created inclined conical cavities that were remodeled into shallow elliptical bays by viscous relaxation. Collision of ice chunks during their ballistic flights altered the trajectories and produced heart-shaped bays at the point of impact. Some ice chunks fragmented when they re-entered the atmosphere from their suborbital space flights and were sent in new trajectories. This could also have produced heart-shaped bays. Prouty wrote that overlapping and heart-shaped bays are most logically explained by the impact of tandem meteorites, some of which were likely explosive in nature. Michael Davies proposed that this heart-shaped bay is a mashup of three Carolina Bay archetype shapes. All three shapes have the identical orientation, but differ in length and eccentricity. In this model, each lobe of the heart conforms to the curvature of a bay. For this particular heart-shaped bay, Prouty's suggestion that two bays form the heart shape requires using very elongated ellipses with width-to-length ratios of about 0.4, which correspond to impact angles of about 24 degrees. These angles are smaller than the typical angle of 35 degrees associated with most Carolina bays, which corresponds to a width-to-length ratio of approximately 0.58. The question of whether the heart-shaped bay represents the mashup of two or three Carolina bays is not easily settled. The advantage of using three bays is that the bays are of standard proportions. Using two bays requires using elongated bays that are not typical, but which are similar to some adjacent bays. The Carolina bays are very accessible along the east coast of the United States. Next time that you visit the Carolinas, keep your eyes open for these enigmatic geological features.